Hey guys, this is Cole Weaver with an update on the LC meter series. Someone asked me recently what's the smallest capacitance that you can measure with the LC meter I built. I got this same question several times actually, and honestly, I couldn't give a precise answer. I guess the smallest capacitor I measured on camera was 2.2 picofarad in part 4 of the series. So for David and for everybody else who has the same question, how low can you measure in terms of capacitance? I'm shooting this experiment. I don't have any capacitor smaller than 1 picofarad, so I'm going to build one out of multiple capacitors in series. Stay tuned, let's get started. I'm sure everybody knows the formula for the series capacitance. So if I have some capacitors connected in series, the series capacitance for C1, C2, C3, and so on till Cn will be calculated with this formula. 1 over Cs, the series capacitance, equals 1 over C1 plus 1 over C2 plus, and so on, 1 over Cn. Right, so basically if we take C1 equals 1 picofarad and C2 equals 1 picofarad, their C series is going to be C1 C2 over C1 plus C2. Trust me on this one. And it will be 1 picofarad over 2 picofarads, which is 0.5 picofarads. If I do this multiple times, let's say 10 times, Cs is going to be around 0.1 picofarad. So I'm going to look for the smallest capacitors I can find. Right here, 1 picofarad. These are the smallest ones. I don't have any smaller than that. So we're going to build a smaller capacitor out of these ones. I only have 5 of them. So this means using our formula here five times 1 picofarad capacitors. The series capacitance should be 0.2 picofarad. I'm going to use a spare PCB I had around to solder these capacitors in series. And I'm also going to add some terminals because it makes measuring a lot easier. One more thing I forgot. It would be nice to measure at least one of these capacitors, because otherwise we're assuming they're 1 picofarad. .07 picofarads. Now let's put this into our formula and we'll assume they're all 1.07 pico. And their series capacitance, 1 over Cs, will be 1 over 1.07 plus 1 over 1.07 plus 1 over 1.07 plus 1 over 1.07 plus one more. So 1 over Cs equals 0.9345 multiplied with 5, which is 4.6728. So the series capacitance should be around 0.214, 0.21 picofarads. Let me just change the probes now. I'm gonna wait till it finishes calibration. And now carefully place our new capacitor on the probes. And let's see. Zero point twenty six picofarads, which I believe is pretty good. At this level, everything counts. First of all, we assumed that all these capacitors are 1.07 pico. So if only one of them is a little bit over this number, the capacitance will change. Second of all, I did solder these 5 capacitors, adding a little bit of capacitance each time I added solder. Even the heat coming from the tip of my soldering iron is modifying the capacitance. And lastly, I still use these probes and leads, which proved to perform extraordinary under these circumstances. Measuring 200-ish femto, remember we crossed the pico domain, we're now into femto divisions, and measuring femto of anything is not a trivial task. Although there's so much that can be improved with this design, I would change the way it powers. I would change the battery, the voltage regulator too. I would add a sleep and a wake-up function in software. I could use a more precise oscillator for the microcontroller. The microcontroller itself, it would be better to run at higher frequencies. The software, there are so many things I would do better. The calibration routine, the way it does the averaging after each measurement. Let's just say there's a lot of stuff that can be improved. But still, this design has proved its magic. It can be improved, not necessarily as in precision. Precision is crazy enough the way it is, but in stability and maybe functionality too. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this series. I thought I was done with it after part 4, but you never know. If David and others wouldn't ask questions like this, there wouldn't be answers. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe if you didn't already, and I'll see you on the next one. This is Cole Weaver, signing off.